I have Crohn's disease. Crohn's is a chronic illness, so it's never gonna go away. It's basically a disease where your stomach is inflamed, and it can be life-threatening, like it was for me. So I was diagnosed with Crohn's in 2019. It's crazy because I made a senior thesis film. And when I did that, I had no idea what was in store. Things started to turn really bad quickly. It all happened, I would say, in a week.
You feel so sick.
I would go to the bathroom and it would look like a murder scene. And then I was getting these crazy fevers. I developed what we later on learned was called an elephant's ear. It was so painful. I was screaming on the top of my lungs. And I looked at my mom and I was like, we need to go to the emergency room. And we did. I got to the hospital January 31st and I did not leave till March 12th. I ended up being in two hospitals during all of this. We lost a lot of time being at the first hospital. It got to a point where I got really sick that I stopped even recognizing myself. I lost so much weight. You would see my bones sticking out. My mom practically cried when I took off my pants to take a shower. She looked at me and she's like, you're so small. I was getting these crazy fevers. It was over 103. I also remember filming a POV and looking in the bed and seeing the clumps of hair. And I caught it on camera, my initial reaction of my hair falling out. They honestly didn't realize what was happening in my stomach. When I ended up transferring, I had such deep ulcers, they were like, you might be in emergency surgery any second. They decided to put me on this medicine that I was avoiding for 2 years. It's called Remicade. I was terrified to use it because it's related to cancer, and I thought, hey, my Crohn's isn't that bad, why would I risk getting cancer? They decided while I was in the hospital they wanted to do this test called a sigmoidoscopy. This was probably one of the worst parts of being in the hospital. You're supposed to be under anesthesia for this because they're going inside of you with a camera. And they didn't know if they wanted to do this test because of how sick I was, and my team forgot to tell me not to eat breakfast that morning. I then find out I'm going down for the test, and I find out I can't go under anesthesia for it. Keep in mind, I am in severe pain. I also, on top of it, had like blood clots coming out. My doctor comes in and says, hey, we're gonna do the test anyway. You're just gonna be awake. And I look at him like he was crazy. I thought he was making jokes. He goes, no, we're doing it. I felt completely violated. I had three nurses hold me down, and I was screaming on the top of my lungs, you can't do this to me. I don't feel safe, I don't feel comfortable, I'm in so much pain. I begged for pain medicine, and they gave me that, but I said, I don't feel the pain medicine, can you wait till I feel it? And my doctor just started sticking his finger inside of me. They couldn't get the camera in because that's how sick I was. They said I was so inflamed that even if I was put to sleep, they physically just could not fit the camera inside of me. It was just terrible. So I think that definitely was one of the things that really affected me out of the hospital.
So you're experiencing now some PTSD.
After that, I decided to change doctors and my whole team was changed. Things got really bad once I got to the second hospital.
Hey Lindsay, it's Mommy. I hope you're okay.
I just remember waking up from the anesthesia and being kind of out of it. My doctor looking at me saying, Lindsay, we have to remove your colon. They basically said that I was just gonna get a bag out of my stomach for the rest of my life. When they told me that, I obviously had a big freak out. My mom and I were like, let's talk other options before we jump to this. We decided to try another dosage of Remicade, but double it. Little did we know that was going to be the worst decision we could have ever made. This one option might work. I'm getting a really high dosage of treatment of Remicade. Fingers crossed it works. Deciding to do a double dosage of Remicade was the absolute worst idea. It started to clear up my Crohn's and doing its work, but it caused a whole other issue. I wake up to finding out my liver enzymes are skyrocketing. Every single day, we started waking up in fear, seeing the numbers jump higher and higher to the point where they were like, she might go into liver failure. The problem was they weren't sure if it was the medicine or if I was having another underlying disease. I had to go in for another procedure.
I got a biopsy of my liver.
where they cut open my neck and went down and cut open my liver to take out pieces to test. Turns out I am one of the rare cases where Remicade caused a liver injury. Thankfully, my doctors caught it, otherwise I would have had liver failure. That meant though, I had to stop treatment that was working and either try another treatment, which was 25 to 50% chance of causing liver failure, or I could go get my colon removed.
These are not easy decisions, man. I literally feel like I might actually die.
I one morning wake up and can't feel my legs. So the nurse ends up calling rapid response and ICU doctors, and I am completely convinced I'm going paralyzed. I start passing out and speaking nonsense. I swore that there were cows in the hospital room, and I was blankly staring and unresponsive. Turns out my blood pressure was so low that my mind was just not mentally there. And because of the low blood pressure, I physically couldn't feel myself in my own body. And machines hooked me at all times to monitor my blood pressure. This was happening for days, to the point where they had to change my team, and I had multiple doctors' eyes on me at all times. It sort of felt like an outer body experience. They said I had a 25 to 50% chance of having liver failure with one of these drugs, or I could have my colon removed. And I said, fuck it, let's do the treatment. So I started Humira.
I'm going home.
Thankfully, I have been on Humira ever since.
Once you press that button, don't let it go, okay? Ready? Go ahead.
I am doing a lot better now, but we don't know again if my liver is going to fail from this. So I am checking every single week my numbers.
Oh, that was not bad. I can't believe it.
Spent my whole life chasing.
I'm going home.
Just to end up turned around, took me to dark places.
Being in the hospital that long really took a toll on my mental health. I definitely feel like I have a lot of support. I think it's difficult because none of them physically went through it. So they could be there for as much as they want, but they like don't know what that feeling is. I can't even like explain out loud how painful it was then, like, to feel like you're not. You might not wake up the next morning. I have all these new worries and fears that I never expected to have at my age. I'm so afraid to get older. And like, I never thought about that. I also really want to make sure to make a point that my disease doesn't become my identity. I don't know how to mentally cope with all of this. Like, how do you go back to a normal life now? Honestly, I'm facing a lot of PTSD, from procedures to diagnosis, to even waking up and reliving the same nightmare over and over and over again. I also learned that I am so much stronger than I ever thought. I want to live life to the fullest. There's so much I want to do. I now know that it can be stolen from you in the matter of seconds.